Postbank has announced its financial results with a 19% increase in net profit for last year. The state-owned bank further reported a net profit of 15.1 billion shillings, a solid year over growth of 19.3%, up from the 12.2 billion net profit posted in 2021. Officials also reported that Postbank's total assets grew significantly by 21.3% from 745 billion in 2021 to 946.6 billion shillings in 2022, which is close to 1 trillion shillings, and this has been attributed to the bank's digital transformation journey that began in 2020.
The general default rate in Uganda is always between 4 to 5%. So on average, every 100 shillings that you give out, 4 or 5 will not return. So it's really a very big challenge. And it is our job to support customers either through a lot of financial literacy, a lot of information, creating awareness and monitoring and follow up to make sure that the ones who lend money can actually pay. Plus, of course, the cost of appraising a customer. That is a high cost again, to be very sure that the money you are giving out is actually going to come back.
Our journey to serve the parish development model right across the country with a solution that ensures funds reach the final beneficiary right across the different districts of this country. Now, the bank has grown right across different performance parameters. Our total assets grew by 27%. We're just below a trillion, 946 billion. Our deposits grew by 36% to about 989 billion, while our profitability grew as well by 24%. Last year, we were at 12, we're now at 15 billion, and we'll continue to grow. Considering where the bank was 3 years ago, we've made tremendous strides in the right direction.
The State Minister for Investment and Privatization, Evelyn Anite, commended the board and management of Postbank for the good performance over the last 3 years.
Our focus really is the manufacturers. How do we address the issue of capital to the manufacturers? And we can only do that if we give more money to Postbank, and Postbank drops its interest rates. Other development countries like German, they will give it to you at 1%, 2%. That's where we want to go. But we can't do it overnight. We have to keep on growing the bank. So if all of you come in and support this bank, all of us, we support this bank, the bank will be able to have enough capital. Therefore, lending it out back to you will not be at 23% or 12%. It will come as low as 6 or 5%, which is something that we have to all aspire for.
Report compiled by Jaliet Namuwaya for the news.